श्योर,
है ना?
सो यू कैन प्रोसीड अहेड।
Namaskar everybody. Welcome to the dairy webinar organized by AgNext. My name is Soumya and I am representing AgNext, which is an agri-tech company trying to infuse the AI-based technologies into agriculture supply chains, specifically dairy sector, with the objective to bring adulteration-free milk to everybody. As we all know that the world is facing an economic slowdown and India too has not remained untouched of the same. COVID-19 pandemic and the subsequent lockdowns have affected largely from common man to businesses and dairy sector, despite of falling under essential commodity. It has two faced problem regarding supply chain production as well as manpower. The main objective of our webinar today is COVID-19 and dairy sector automation, is to gain insights from the industry experts on how technology can play an important role in the fighting of issues related to various levels of the dairy sector, and how in these unprecedented times, consumer remains satisfied of the quality of dairy product they are consuming. So first of all, let me just run you all through the flow of the webinar. We will start with the introduction of our panelist, followed by the viewpoint of our expert panelist over the burning issues. And then we will take some questions from our participants, and finally we will have the closing remarks. Before we go any further, I want to let our audiences know that your active participation is important throughout the session. During the session, everyone will be on mute to avoid the background noises. You can enter your questions and comments in the Q&A section throughout the presentation. Not taking much of your time, I would now like to introduce our eminent speaker panel, starting with Dr. J.V. Parekh. With his outstanding achievements and 50 plus years of his glorious career, presently is helping the dairy industry as an international consultant to dairy and food industry and serving as a CEC member of the Indian Dairy Association, New Delhi. Our second eminent panelist for today is Dr. Rakesh Mohan Joshi, a distinguished academician, an eminent author, and a renowned management expert. He's the professor and chairperson research with Indian Institute of Foreign Trade. Thirdly, I would like to extend a warm welcome to Dr. K.S. Murthy, business head, ITC Analytical Services Business. He has been actively involved in creating analytical technology platform through the collaborations with academia and various startups. Last but not the least, we have with us respected Mr. Pradeep Chakrabarty, former director FSSAI. He has an extensive 35 plus years of experience in the field of food processing, quality control, project management, and export of processed foods. Mr. Chakrabarty is working as a food safety consultant, visiting faculty of D.Y. Patil University, and senior advisor, Center for Public Health and Food Safety. It's an honor for us to welcome you all, sir. Now, my colleague, Mr. Salil Lakhanpal, would take the session forward. Over to you, Salil.
Sure. Thanks, Soumya. I welcome all the experts in this decision. Also, thanks to all of the viewers that are attending this session. So just setting the context straight, so India being the largest producer of the milk in the world captures approximately 22% of the total market share. So it is approximately double of the production of the second largest producer, which is US. So we believe that milk as an agriculture commodity has a very high strategic as well as financial importance to the economy of India. This can be highlighted with the fact that, milk approximately contributes 26% of the agricultural GDP in India, which is greater than the combined value of wheat and paddy. So this scale of production is basically highly fragmented, owing to approximately 400 million liters per day of production from approximately 7.5 crore farmers collected through more than 4 lakh collection centers across 3.5 lakh villages and 430 districts, and finally catering to approximately 1,500 plus plants. So this is a very exhaustive and, you know, widely spread supply chain, and a pandemic like COVID would have hugely impacted the complete supply chain and in context of collection, distribution, as well as consumption. So I would like to, you know, take this opportunity to, you know, have views of Dr. J.V. Parekh to know how tech innovations are helping the industry to cope up with this challenge, and how we will come out of this as a collaborative measure. So over to you, Mr. Parekh.
Many thanks, Ali, and also the AgriTech Technology, your company, for inviting me to share some of our thoughts. I would also like to thank to Samia Parekh. She was doing continuous follow up with me. So we like to thank very much. I was also very happy to see our all the old friends here. Dr. Chakravarti is there, Dr. Murthy is there, Dr. I think Sarva has already joined now, I think so. So all are on the panel now. So I think we'll be discussing more. We also invite our all CEC members and other dairy faculty. So I think it is a very interesting interaction to talk about the subject is more on the COVID-19 and how the automation can happen in the dairy industry to improve the quality of the milk. So now I think more than 60 days that we are running through this COVID period, and we have a lot of challenges has come. When we started, I think when it was the first lockdown was there in the March, I think on 24th, about 3 weeks lockdown was there. So it was a very big surprise for the dairy industry, because we are a 24/7 industry. At 365 days, we work always, cows give the milk, and we have to process and handle it the problem. So this is how the challenge has taken place from the beginning, but we had a lot of ups and downs. Initially, there was a problem of the even milk procurement problem was there. So small producers or small dairy plants, they could not in a position to supply the milk. And even a lot of other problems were there in the letting the milk to the plant. Particularly more problems were there with the those who don't have much backward integration, like some of the small and the medium scale. But cooperative had a very strong backward integration, and they could procure the milk at the right time. But initially about 3-4% there was a shortage of the procurement, and the market was also down because liquid milk has gone substantially down because most of the restaurants, hotels, the shops were also closed down. So I was told that total procurement was down about 3-4%, and milk sales and liquid milk sales has gone down to 15-20%. So this is how the scenario started moving on till the 15th of the April, and then we had a lot of improvement in the procurement system, logistics, and now a person can understand the whole the dairy industry, you know, starting from the farmer to the consumer whole chain, and it has been taken a lot of care to improve the procurement system and the marketing also. So whenever there was a need of the safety of the milk also, that is very important to see that starting from the society level to the consumer, milk safety is well maintained. And because this is a new thing for this, even for this collection point, to provide proper the mask or provide the sanitizers and help to keep it at distance. So that was sort of a challenge was there from the beginning. Till that there is no transporters and the milk processing plant. So some of the guidelines has came afterwards, what we call SOP, standard operating procedure, to see that milk has been properly processed and tried to be remain untouched with the human hand. So this and the distribution also, there was a problem because most of the shops were also closed, and the logistics was also difficult. So basically, initially, milk marketing has gone down. and particularly the private sector, a lot of milk was available with them, and liquid milk was down. So most of the private, even cooperatives, started consuming the milk solids in terms of milk powder, in terms of the white butter, ghee, and USP milk, and some of the cheese and other products. So this product has a little bit increased the market share. So you can see the whole chain was because being a, you know, our is essentially industry like medicine and the milk, so it has to supply. So our farmers were protected. They were made the, you know, almost the cash payment. So that was a good support to them. And both the cooperatives and the private were tried to do best to collect the milk. But generally, we find that liquid milk market more was with the cooperative sector. They could need to pay more price, maybe about 25 to 30 rupees per liter of the cow milk. Whereas the private sector, they were consuming the milk for it, mainly in the milk powder and the ghee. So the price is a little bit paid to the producer or less, maybe 20 to 25 rupees.
Sir, I would like to pause you for 1 minute. Can you please speak closer to the mic? We only very low voice we can hear. So okay. A little louder.
Hear me now?
Yes, sir. Thank you. Sorry for pausing you, sir. Please continue.
So some of the hygienic guidelines were followed, and accordingly the milk has been now, we have got a lot of availability of the milk powders and this ghee and other products. So then we're going to the market now for the milk and milk products. The industry is doing very well in terms of, even milk procurement. I was told by cooperatives, some of the dairy plants, the milk procurement has increased even 15% to 20%. Private sector is also collecting the milk. So most total procurement is now about 100 million liters of milk per day by both the sectors. And both the sectors are doing excellent and making many of the products. So now most of the products like cheese, butter, paneer, the market has grown up. Liquid milk market is also growing about 4 to 5%. As a whole, the industry is in a good hand, and consumers are also not going much out because of this COVID period, so they are taking at home. So most of the products are consumed at home, so like liquid milk and USP milk. So that market has also increased. As a whole, the situation has a very good, and government, some of the schemes are also given. So that will also boost this, some of the milk production. Even so many migrants, labor has gone to the villages, from the city to the villages. That will also help to generate some of the dairy farming. Now we have got animal husbandry department has also given some 15,000 crore rupees to increase the infrastructure facilities. So that is increase the milk production, generating of the some jobs in the dairy sector.
Sure.
So a lot of development will take backward integration as well as the forward integration. So I think dairy industry have a very good bright future. Market will grow also. There should be a export market also is subsequently. So dairy industry is excellent, doing very well. Thank you.
Thanks for this valuable input, sir. It was really insightful. Meanwhile, Dr. Joshi has also joined us. We welcome you, sir. Also, all of the viewers that are seeing us, I think it will be great if you can share your question and answers into the Q&A panel and not in the chat. So using Q&A panel, we'll be able to address them better. Also, Parik sir, I completely understand that, you know, the demand as well as the production and the distribution has come up to a place where we see that the industry has bounced back and is recovering well. However, due to this pandemic, a lot of institutional consumers as well as private consumers are kind of not, favoring unorganized distribution of milk, which approximately, covers 71% of our surplus market of milk. So how do you think the unorganized milk distribution segment will respond to it? Do you think there will be decrease in demand and, favor of private consumers for unorganized distribution and accepting milk from these guys? Or do you think that it will bounce back as well?
Well, the answer is very simple because now.
Sir, you got muted.
For yes. Products, so people will not go with the loose milk. Most of the milk is remains loose in the unorganized sector. So unorganized sector will need to be reduced, and whatever we are processing now, about 20-25% of the total milk production, it will go maybe to 30-35%. Because people like to have a more branded and more hygienic packed product. So whatever the milk available will be reduced, and I think there will be increase of the branded quality, which will give more boosting from individual products, which will be more healthy and more nutritious product. So I think that will be the future scope for the dairy industry, and I think unorganized sector will have a little bit, has to go to the organized sector.
But do you think, sir, for the players that are operating in the unorganized distribution, do you think it will be easy for them to shift to, you know, packed products and, you know, channel all that milk to packed products? So do you think it will be easy for these players to do that?
Yeah, most of the small many manufacturers and those are the, you know, like a middleman, because a lot of government schemes are available, as I mentioned to you, 15,000 crore has been sanctioned under the Animal Husbandry Department. So this money will be utilized for this infrastructure development, where startup will come, and that will generate more than 5 crore liter of the milk. But consumer would like to have more branded product. So unorganized sector has to go with a more hygienically production or processing plant, which will help to generate have a better market. And those who are with the local brand, which will give the consistent quality product, you know, a lot of flexibility there will also have a, will be the better. But basically, scope is for the more untouched hygienic product in the future.
Sure, sir, sure. So also, you know, following up on that question, I would like Dr. Murthy to express his thoughts. So basically, for sure, the unorganized milk distribution sector has to, you know, shift to organize, you know, start selling packaged products. So since ITC also market their private brand for milk, so I would like Dr. Murthy to give us some inputs. How do you think that unorganized sector face challenges once they set up organized milk distribution, and what are, how tech helps these private organized dairies to market and produce their products? So over to you, Murthy sir.
Hi, good morning, Salil, and good morning, everyone. Thanks for this invite. It's a good delight to be a part of it. Very eminent other speakers who had spent their life in dairy, and my exposure is hardly to any extent in the dairy sector. So just let me share my thoughts. It's initially before the white revolution and now, then the challenge was to carry the milk to a place. Milk naturally is the most suitable body absorbable nutrients that it provides, I think, except vitamin D. So it's the sought after source of nutrition for anyone as childbirth or a very, very elderly people, anybody would absorb this nutrition. So that's where the importance of milk comes in, not only in India, even in the Western world, where the diet depends largely on meat. Coming to this point, there the challenge was the perishability. And there was no infrastructure to store it. There were not chilling plants, and also there were no technology or the infrastructure in terms of converting it into a milk powder, skimmed milk powder, and restore the nutrients, yet make it available to the public in large scale. So too much of emphasis was given on the infrastructure, automations, on the later part of the value chain. What I mean is not sourcing, communicating to the chilling plants, but from the chilling plants to the manufacturing where the milk powder is produced. So there is no dearth of automation. If I give you the example of Danone, the state of the art of the plant has been closed due to the non-availability of the desired quality of the milk. Danone has got a particular quality, and their supply chain has not been able to produce the same kind of milk through the rural network or through the contract farming or whatever it is. So due to the quality mismatch, they have closed the plant. So the point here to make is there is no shortage in terms of the technology to produce a packet milk, make it available, And you know, the manufacturing of the skimmed milk powder or the chili. The issue is aggregation. In India, the small farm, you would find hardly very few farmers who have got 10 animals. To the animals, where you would find an animal size, the milk size per day, 80 liters to 100 liters. So the aggregation is the challenge. In view of this challenge, the quality monitoring has been challenged. I would like to emphasize on big pharma and quality testing and disintegration. Because of the large disintegration at the soil, once the product reaches at the chilling unit, then, you know, the basic tests have been conducted and people are been able to take the real decisions, then you know you can convert it into a value added form. And then the challenge of perishability is restricted. So in that way, it can be made available to the public. So now the issue is the challenge of, you know, the increasing the shelf life, the perishable issues, basically the decreasing the microbiological load at the source are the major challenges. Packing means need not be a packing in a branded format like RDC does or Amul does. The semi-urban consumption and the 3-4 tiers of the consumption, all of a sudden we cannot increase the infrastructure of the supply chain from a completely, you know, a loose form of selling to a completely branded form of the selling. These are the two extreme cases.
Exactly.
COVID has come suddenly and the entire supply chain is not ready. For example, I'll tell you, the cost of aggregation, as far as the manpower is concerned, it is around 15 to 20 paisa per liter. The field people who are involved to collect and take it to the chilling. If I give a quality solution that matches to 10 paisa, the economics won't match. So similarly, we are converting into the packing. I'll give you one more example. The cost of chilling unit comes to 7 to 8 lakhs. And if I give a solution at 5 lakhs, the economics won't match. So here, the issue, the challenge is the unit economics. Not only for the packing, for the quality also. Like, thank you for sharing the FSSAI report on the aflatoxins. That's a quite a bit of deductions in these things. Okay. The unconventional way of detection, we as an extent ITC has come out with a solution which is, you know, 350 rupees vis-a-vis 2500 rupees cost of testing. Issue is not that. Even this cost itself is pretty expensive for milk industry to adapt before the chilling, where the actually the production happens. But actually the economics has to match. Anything between, you know, we might think that we have given a state-of-the-art and a next-generation technology solution, but the unit economics has to match to make it economically viable for adopting. So as far as the packing is concerned, the basically what we are trying to say, the loose is more vulnerable to the exposure and the packing is a solution where you would increase the hygiene. Am I correct in my understanding, Salil?
Yes, sir, yes.
The issue here is not the form of the packing. Here is increasing the hygiene at the source itself. If you look back in the first term of Prime Minister's campaign, the Swachhta Hi Seva, the Swachh Bharat campaign, increasing the hygiene for the human beings. So your dependency on the hospital or the drug would decrease. So your diseases are decreased. Same as the best way to disease control for the animals and the antibiotic doses would reduce by increasing the natural hygiene levels and increasing the supply chain efficiencies, reducing the microbiological loads, and give a solution which are extremely cost effective by times, which includes testing as well. So these are the three points that I wanted to mention. And I would summarize the point of mention is, issue is not in terms of the infrastructure. We have greater infrastructural solutions to make it a skimmed powder or powder. Issue is in terms of the make it available at the source itself and increase the hygiene level so that your disease control becomes more effective. And, you know, the cost of control load comes down. And if we want to integrate the quality, it's not very difficult. A cost-effective solution that matches the unit economics of the entire production, the product becomes cheaper. The comparison, I'll give you the reference is 15 paisa is spent on managing the entire manpower cost to make the product reach to the chilling unit. If I give a quality session of 10 paisa, it would be expensive. So these are three points that I would like to mention.
Sure, sir. I think these were really insightful, sir, for sure. We understand the fact that, you know, shifting the complete unorganized milk distribution to packaged solution is not something that industry it is feasible to explore, because it involves a lot of financial investment, as rightly mentioned by you, the economics. It is a great challenge to match the economics once the packaged product is into the market. Sure, sir. Thanks for that insight. So moving on to since we mentioned the, you know, cost involved in all you know, transforming this unorganized distribution to organized. So in any case, we will need to advance our infrastructure that is into the supply chain. So I have a question for Dr. Joshi here. So sir, with approximately, you know, 15,000 crores of grant is given to animal husbandry infrastructure under the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan Economic Stimulus Package. So how do you think that, you know, this financial package will reach the players into the dairy industry, and how effective do you think will that be for the industry to, you know, increase the bar of automation as well as quality assessment across the supply chain, so that the immediate need of packaged as well as safe products of consumer is addressed? So over to you, Dr. Joshi.
Thank you. I think it's a great question. I think first you have brought about Atmanirbhar, which I think I don't understand what does it mean by Atmanirbhar, because India, as you've seen, that over the periods our agriculture imports have increased rather than exports. And I think my personal estimate is in next 10 years India is going to be the net importer of agriculture produce. Atmanirbhar, sure, you are talking of at the time of India's independence, our share in the world export was 2.4%, which has now come to 1.7%, and we are continuing with a share of 1.7% for last 10 years. So I am not very sure that what we are doing. Another thing, when it comes to, I am sure that you are aware of, you talk of the, you know, even if you talk of, you know, you are sitting in Chandigarh, very near to you is Himachal, and you know, India imports almost 200,000 to 300,000 tons of you know, what we call this apples from China and America. In 90 to 98% of the almonds are being imported. So I think I'm not very sure. And I think all these imports have grown in the recent years. Number one. But I think what I'm, let me talk about the dairy industry. I'm very happy. Dairy industry is the only industry which is Atmanirbhar. We don't need imports. We don't need import. Dairy industry is very Atmanirbhar. And dairy industry has done with no other industry has done. India has become the largest milk producer on the earth, but and I think the credit absolutely goes to the cooperative movement that India do, which nobody could do. And India, with a cattle size of 2 to 3 cattle, we became you know, the large milk you know, the largest milk producer. And I think more than the government, the credit goes to the culture of the people of this country, because we know how to take milk. Nobody else in the world knows how to take milk. I am not very sure you know or not that in America, the first cow, you know, arrived only 400 years back, 400, 500. Okay. India, we have cows for 2,000, 3,000 years, every, you know, right from our civilization. China milk taking is only 100 years. But so what, it is our culture, and therefore, and another thing, we are vegetarian. And this COVID-19 is pushing many people to be vegetarian. And I think, you know, blessing in disguise. When the jobs are disappearing in India, like you see that 27% almost, you know, in the first week of May, the unemployment rate in India was almost 27.4%. Anyway, some employment was given in last few weeks, and the last data available is 23-24% of the unemployment. There is reverse migration of the people from urban areas to the rural area. That is extremely important. Now, I think I'm very sure is what is very important is that transformation of the industry from urban areas to the rural areas. And this is, I think, where we need to focus on. And dairy is one which is absolutely wonderful. Now, with this 15,000 crore of rupees, which you talk, I'm not very sure, because the 20 lakh crore rupees, the package was there. But most of the part of the package was in terms of the credit and, you know, to create liquidity. You know, another thing is this package, and reforms also, like we have done the reforms in the APMs, in the agriculture marketing. But what is here very important is that, you know, the building dairy infrastructure is absolutely important. I think dairy we require it. And with this, I think employment can be given to somewhere between 1.5 crore people in the country. So I think that is extremely important. We can process, we can process about 1.5 crore liters of milk with this. The only thing which, I've been telling, I'm writing almost, every 2-3 days in some of the economic newspapers and magazines, wherein you see the whole problem comes in implementation.
Sure.
And for implementation, I think I will not be very critic to the milk industry, but let me tell you one important thing is your prices need to be competitive, with the international market, which I am very sure that you are so many experts from dairy, so you can find out how competitive you are. You are aware, my senior colleague and guide Dr. Parikh is there, so he will tell you that how tooth and nail we fought for arsen. We went to the extent that some people are providing wrong data. Anyway, I sided with the dairy industry that time that we should. But, at all international forum we were. Dr. Parikh was there with the world, the dairy summit. Dr. Ajoria was also there. So we fought tooth and nail. But I think, let me tell at this forum, there is no shortcut to your becoming competitive. Your cost of production, you need to be competitive. And I think today also, 2 days back, this FAO information come. Food prices in the last 2 months have dipped. Even the April, they have dipped. And more dip has taken place in the dairy prices, where the price in the butter and the cheese because of less demand. Now, unless there is a demand, I was having in the chat question, how to create demand. I think, whose question this was, but I think it's a $1 million question who has asked. I think it's the problem which, no governments are, willing to give, how to create demand. And I think, incidentally, I'm a dairyman turned into the marketing expert, so I can tell you, if there is a demand and you can provide a price, now, what the cooperatives have done, they have done to create a demand. Now, this 15,000 crore rupees basically goes into the infrastructure, but again, the problem is, the implementation part of the problem. I think that is left to the functioning authority. So, and another thing is the demand creation, because of the joblessness and, not only India, but across the world. And now, the markets are opening up. I think it's a very interesting when the debt toll is going up and markets are opening up, to what extent the market will be open, whether the countries will be willing to, the people will be able to get the re-employment. Even if they get the employment, the economies are, already forecasted to decline by 3%. By the IMF, but don't go by the data because data change every time. Now, even the India, the decline in the last 2-3 months has been much more. And decline in India is expected to be 6-9% now. And I'm very sure that it can even go further down. So we do not know what is going to happen. So under any circumstances, the price, if not decline, it is not going to increase. And therefore, I think it is on the individual dairy federations or the dairy operators that please take a shot. And, prior to this, I don't know you know or not, prior to this in 2019, the world market demand was less by 3%. The world export was less by 3%. India's export was less by 0.1%. Now, when you come to this place, this year, the export in India is going to decline by 20-25%. The world export somewhere is going to decline somewhere between 13-32%. So what is going to happen is, so demand scenario in time to come is not, not very rosy. So given the constraint, the secret of success lies in your becoming efficient and efficiently transforming the urban industries into the rural center, like in Germany. Germany, if you go to a dairy farm, every dairy farm, German, they have got big dairy farm. And even if not big, say one person got 50 cows or 100 cows. So with the 1500 cows, he has got own processing unit and local brands are sold across German market. But this thing is not there in the Indian market because I think we don't have that big herd of the cow. 2-3 cows, so local cooperative, local processing, local logistics, and then achieving the economies of scale at that. I think that will determine the secret of success for the dairy industry at the individual level, at the village level. And if the dairy succeeds, so we'll be able to have that cost. Now, I'm getting telephones from various, dairy federations. Private prices bhi gir gayi hain. Prices प्राइस इज गॉन फ्रॉम 15% टू 50% तक लोगों ने प्राइस गिरा दी है. कोऑपरेटिव के अंदर दूध का प्रोक्योरमेंट 15% बढ़ गया है. सो यू नो ऑल दीज थिंग्स इज टू बी एडजस्टेड. एक डेयरी कमिश्नर ने मुझे फोन किया, उसने कहा साहब क्या कर रहे हैं बताइए आप क्या करते हैं, हमने तो सारे कलेक्टर्स को कहा. सो यू नो ऑल दीज थिंग्स वी हैव टू नीड, लेकिन देयर इज नो शॉर्टकट टू योर अटेनिंग एफिशिएंसी एंड ऑपरेटिंग इन दीज कंडीशंस.
श्योर आई थिंक this is very insightful that even if you know 15,000 crore of packages transferred to the industry, it is first you know implementation that they need to take care of, and then for sure using that implementation if there is increase in the
one more thing, the 15 crore package is not going to help you in the short term or even in the medium term. These it can help only in the long term. And I think day before yesterday, I have not read that. The government says all the planned expenditure are come to the halt. So I do not know whether it will fall or not.
Sure. So as you say, sir, in the longer term or even in the shorter terms, the industry, the immediate point of action is to create demand and then to see how employing technology and putting in investment for increasing infrastructure helps you or not. So thanks, sir. It was very insightful. Thank you. So moving the focus of this webinar to the regulatory bodies, I think I would like to involve Mr. Pradeep Chakraborty. So, sir, setting up the context, how we wanted to discuss this was that, you know, the first ever survey of milk conducted in May 2018, FSSAI discovered that approximately 41% of milk samples fell short of some kind of safety parameters. So out of approximately 6,000 samples tested, 456 were found unsafe due to contaminants such as aflatoxin, antibiotics, or pesticides. And approximately 48% of the total samples were found non-compliant. So I just want to, have your views on how FSSAI has worked to develop regulation and how these regulations have been implemented across industry and how FSSAI is planning to, promote the implementation of technology to address this issue. Over to you, Pradeep, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello. Yeah, good morning to everybody. In today's webinar, we are going to discuss on dairy sector in view of COVID-19 pandemic situation, I believe.
Yes,
and all of us know that the importance of milk in our daily life. We are the largest producer of milk in the world. At the same time, we are also the. Hello.
Yes, Modi sir, can you please mute yourself?
Yeah, and at the same time, we are also the largest consumer of milk. Also.
Sure, sir.
So. The processed milk products are insignificant compared to other countries. In fact, we process only 6.9% of our agricultural produce, which is much below than most of the countries. With the government of India announcing this nationwide lockdown on March 24, 2020, due to the outbreak of COVID-19, most of the FMCG company in India, like Amul, was in a major fix. The pandemic situation was extremely critical, since milk supply is an essential service. Automation in dairy sector has played an important role. Big companies like Amul had signed a 10-year partnership with IBM back in 2009, which has been renewed for another 10 years. This has enabled end-to-end visibility to supply chain. Unlike other dairy units, Amul has a very complex supply chain. It does not start from a factory or from a supplier. It starts from the source of the milk production. A complete disaster recovery solution was a must. The IT initiatives were designed to enhance visibility and transparency across the value chain.
Sure.
With IBM's help, Amul is integrating new technologies with farmers and retailers. While Amul, with its scale and distribution, may have benefited during the lockdown, there is a massive dip in procurement and sale of dairy products in other small dairy units. With demand dipping, procurement has also reduced. COVID-19 pandemic situation has changed the world altogether. Now the focus of the industry, particularly the food processing industry, has been shifted from reactive role to proactive role. Dairy industries deals in milk and milk products. FSSAI has specified standards for dairy products and analogs. We have specified standards, and all these standards have been notified in our website, www.fssai.gov.in. And earlier, actually, it was only dairy products and analogs. Now we have actually standards for this fortified milk also. Though milk fortification is a very old thing. In fact, it started in 1980s to combat malnutrition in India. But it was stopped after 1989 because it was a central government project and subsidy was stopped. So most of the companies, those who are fortifying milk, has stopped this. But some of the companies, particularly cooperative societies, seven in Maharashtra, and seven in Rajasthan and two in Maharashtra, they continued fortification of milk with vitamin A and D. But then actually, that time I was director in FSSAI, and one of our food safety officer in Rajasthan, they actually prosecuted this one of the Rajasthan cooperative that they are they are actually fortifying milk, because as per definition of milk, as per our regulation, nothing should be added to milk and nothing should be extracted also from the milk, since they are adding vitamins actually. So it is violation of the regulation. So they were prosecuted, in fact. So then actually it was taken up at the central government level and state level also. Then actually we have come out with this regulation of fortified milk with milk fortification with vitamin A and D to combat malnutrition. So fortified milk regulation is also in there. So in addition to more fortification in milk, we have allowed fortification in cereals, oils, and some other on six types of six category of products, where because vitamin A and D and malnutrition and this not only vitamins, micronutrients and iron deficiency is very prominent in India. So all these regulations are there in our website, and we have the book also. This Food Safety and Standards Act 2006, Food Safety and Standards Regulation 2011, and Food Safety and Standards Rules 2011. All these regulations have been specified in these books as well as in our website. And regarding adulteration, yes, we found a lot of adulteration in milk. And in FSSA, actually, it is actually enforcement lies with both state and central government. Because at center, we have this FSSAI. At every state, actually, we have also a food safety and food safety department headed by one food safety commissioner. Under him, actually, there is licensing officer, DO, we call them. And also the food safety officers. In fact, food safety officers are the backbone in our in this act. And it is their duty, it is the routine duty to lift samples and send it to the laboratory for check for testing. And these laboratories also, they cannot send it to every laboratory. We have notified laboratories, also NABL accredited. They send it to the NABL accredited laboratories, and on the basis of that test report, actually, the licensing officer start prosecution after obtaining approval from the Food Safety Department. But from FSSAI also, from central government also, we did surveillance also on milk products. And in 2010, actually, we did a nationwide survey on milk and milk products. And in 2018 also, again, we did some survey on milk and milk products to check the level of adulteration in milk.
So, sure, sir. So as only thing that, you know, I think what we wanted to know was that, you know, since after this survey, so how do you think, you know, FSSAI has promoted rapid testing technologies? Because, you know, as you were rightly mentioning about adulteration, so when this Officers collect sample, they send it to milk, they, you know, wait for some time to get it, the reports back. How to, is FSSAI taking any steps to, you know, improve the turnaround time of this testing and, you know, implication of any rapid testing technologies that is happening? So any thoughts on that, sir?
Yeah, FSSAI actually already prepared, made some mobile laboratory. These are vans actually. And we have given this to the food safety departments, whoever actually wanted. We gave it free of cost. Only thing that this maintenance and diesel and other things will have to be borne by this respective state governments. So some rapid testing kits are also there. So they can take the van, or particularly the state governments, state food safety department, they can take the van to the rural areas, they can test the quality of milk. And in this way, actually, they can take action also against the erring, against the adulterants. So this is the way, actually, FSSAI thought of. But I would say that enforcement structure of FSSAI is not up to the mark.
So it is, as you rightly mentioned out, sir, it is very reactive. It is not proactive. So once a case of a death or some, you know, a person poisoning out of milk comes up, then FSSAI goes and, you know, shift on the focus of testing and all. So we need to put in a system which is very proactive in place, and, you know, a regular monitoring of adulteration is done across.
Saliliji, doodh mein paani hota hai, toh ye kehte hai adulterated hai. Doodh mein vitamin hota hai, toh ye kehte hai adulterated hai. So the problem is with their laws and not with the milk, and the India in the international get a very bad taste. Kyunki mujhe Amsterdam mein ek mahila mili, unhone kaha sab aapke yahan to doodh hi nahi hota, main chai nahi piti India mein aake. And I think, you know, acha baad mein ye log fir usko amend karte hain apne act ko. So the thing is, you know, even today our regulatory authorities or the organizations are working as a policeman rather than cooperating with the industry, that I will like to say. Pradeep ji, aapko kuch kehna hai to bataiye.
Yeah. Actually, I could not get your question. Adulteration. If you add water into milk, it is adulteration, because customers are being cheated because they are not getting the desired level of.
फिर बता, ये बड़े-बड़े उसमें छाप देता है कि 70% दूध इंडिया का adulterated है. You do whatever you like, but in the international media, it get a very bad taste, and then we cannot export our milk product outside. एक ही fortified milk में इनका दूसरी problem है.
We are sure there is no much adulteration, but adulteration has substantially reduced. That is what the survey of the food safety has also told, and what the consumers also, we are getting feedback. So now compared to the loose milk, packaged milk, branded products, organized dairy milk products are better.
Acha, I will just like to tell you, Salil ji, we have got one participant, Jasbhai Prajapati. He is a scientist and a principal at Anand College. Unko bhi aap on video kar do. I think he is member of that FSSAI committee. Will be able to tell us. Prajapati,
sir, aap hai abhi? Gurpreet, yes, I can see Judge Bhai Prajapati. So if you can, give them access the video.
Prajapati sir, bahut achhe achhe.
What is the full name?
Judge Bhai Prajapati.
Just Bhai Pratapati. So I'm just allowing him to talk. Yeah.
Sure. Mr. Pajapati, welcome to the discussion. So I think you are on mute. You will have to unmute yourself.
Arey, video dikhao Prajapati sam.
Yeah, I've added him in the panel.
हाँ हाँ अच्छा कोई बात नहीं है ना तब तक आप अगला क्वेश्चन पूछ लो.
Sure. So, I think the next question is directed to Dr. Parikh. So, sir, dairy industry works in very close conjunction with the, you know, feed manufacturing, you know, feed silage and such type of industries. So, I just wanted to, you know, had a very brief introduction on how COVID has impacted the feed and silage industry and how tech innovations are helping, you know, this feed manufacturing industry to come over and you know, improve the quality across the bar. So over to you, Dr. Parikh. Then we'll have a discussion with Jaswai Prajapati.
Yeah, I think whatever we are discussing is very nice, but basically dairy industry is a growing consumers are demanding more and milk products. As I told that we are producing about every year we are adding about 6 million tons of the milk. And our milk production is about 4 to 5%. And our marketing also growing about 10 to 15%. So there is a lot of scope. But as I told that we are looking for some of the branded product, packed product, hygienic product, or with the nutrition. Because now a lot of we are talking about the immunizing or immunity of the milk with the addition of some Ayurvedic like tulsi or some turmeric like that. And in the quality. So same thing is happening with the milk product also, because now most of the people are working from home. So that also has added some of the, contribution of the cheese, paneer, butter, that has gone up like a 30-40%. So we find a lot of growth is there in the dairy industry as a whole, because India itself is a big market. Even though it's a producer also, but even the big market. So I think the people are preferring now more and milk products because so much nutritional and immunity properties with that. So there is a lot of scope for the dairy industry to grow. And particularly now with this startup of package, whatever we are seeing, has a lot of impact in the increase in the milk production. Now National Livestock Mission has already started. They're also putting now a lot of new technologies, what we call information and communication technology, what we call the ICT, which will also help to develop this sort of vaccination. And even though all the animals, we have got some about 56 crore animals, all cattle, buffalo, that will be also vaccinated against the foot and mouth disease and plus this brucellosis. So when this is also going to happen, then all the animals will be fed. And there may be also our Aadhaar will be a Krishi Aadhaar. So there are a lot of development will take place, all identification will be taken there, health of the animals, vaccination, about their breeding pattern, that will also improve the quality of the milk and it will improve the productivity of the animal. Now you can see that there is also a call blockchain technology, where you can have traceability of the milk will also happen because all the animals will be tagged, all the information will be available about the pedigree characteristics. So consumers will also know what quality of milk there is, drinking or taking dairy products. So I think whole chain is going to improve, and for that government has funded animal husbandry, has got some, disease control, about 13,000 crore. Even these are all infrastructure development also, which will also boost. Even the cattle feed plants, now we have got always some shortage. And because of the COVID, that cattle feed has gone up to some 50%, I was told, particularly for some of the ingredients. So now we are looking some of the, Ayurvedic milk preparations, along with some NDDB also tried, and some of the least cost formulas, which are the available to bring down the cost. So all the attempts are now made to see that we can have a better quality, balanced life, and a lot of information technology has been generated to help with the increase. So we'll have both the backward integration and forward integration. But basically, India is a big market, and we are trying to improve the quality of the milk. Now we are handling about 25-30%. But if you see after a couple of years, so we may go up to 45-50% by the organized sector. Because consumer preference will be branded, quality packed products. So they will not compromise the because this COVID has improved, hygienic condition will improve, people are becoming more aware. So as a whole, I find very bright future for the dairy industry as long as both, even for the cooperative sector and the private, both are playing equal role. But wherever government support is required, when you conserve some of the working capital requirements, and some of the other small problems are there. So that's where GST is there under some of the products. That has to be reduced. But basically, a lot of scope is there even for this cattle feed. A lot of, still we have got shortage of the cattle feed, so that will be also improved. And I think everybody is working on the research development, new innovation. And we are also inviting a lot of startups will be also generated. And a lot of this, when I told you about so many 50,000-60,000 last people will migrate to home from the village. So that will also create a lot of dairy farming, a lot of dairy industries. Some may put some many dairy plants, some may put quality control, some breeding farms. A lot of dairy ancillary industry can be also developed. So rural economy will also develop. This will even produce more than 5 crore liter milk by this inputs of the technical, I mean 15 lakh crore. So I find a very bright picture, and a lot of learning has been happened with the dairy industry, particularly the hygienic things and all the channels, whatever the logistics were required from the producer to the consumer has been taken care. So I'm very optimistic for the dairy industry, and being we are an essential commodity, like medicine. So I think milk and medicine are doing excellent, and it will grow further. Because our milk is a complete food. I mean, you cannot compare with any other food. It has got high food, so much functional requirement, and all the important nutrients are there, with all the vitamins, minerals, everything. So I think that we have to have a more think about drinking more milk and milk products.
One point here, sir. So in this your description, you just mentioned the blockchain technology and traceability. So I think in the milk industry, since it is a batch processing kind of industry, and in manufacturing, a lot of milk from various collection centers are poured into big storages and then processed for a final product. So how do you think, sir, traceability solutions from product to even cow or a farm can be put in place? Because this is only possible if microprocessing of milk is done. So a brief thought on that, sir?
See, as I mentioned, the blockchain technology has been also proposed. In that, you can have pursue Aadhaar card, something like our, where you can have a traceability of the milk coming from which area. It's like in US also, we have got some certification so the consumer can know that this milk has been purchased from particular that area, which is free or from the disease. But as I mentioned to you, now most of the continuous plant will come more will be automation will be there, starting from that milk production. We have got now DMC, we have got the tanker, so where most of the milk is being untouched, then it will be processed. And then it is packed. Somewhere we find that packing area also, packing and loading and unloading area, there is some manual operations. So most of the bad things will go away, and we'll have a filling center, we'll have also North Pole. So I think the milk cans will go away, and most of the milk will be transported to the milk tanker, which is a more hygienic. And if the milk will be immediately chilled. So wherever that IT technology required information available with that will be transferred. Even this dairy plant, those who are having the manual operation now, small mini dairy plants, 20,000-30,000, that will also be goes for with the PLC operation plants, continuous pasteurizer, and the storage tanks. And a lot of automation will come in the dairy industry, because particularly the product also manufacturing cheese plants or butter plants or powder plants. So I think a lot of revolution will take
place. Sure, sir. And I think the same question is, I think Mr. Prajapati can also address that. How traceability solutions and how transparency of final product to the farm or the cow, how it is being addressed by Amul or this cooperative. So some thoughts on that, Prajapati sir.
Actually, before I give my thought, I had posed a question to Professor Joshi.
Secretly, I told you, Dr. Prajapati is the leading dairy scientist in the country, actually.
I know,
fortunate to have him, and I think he has also been with, working now with Rose now with FFSI. So traceability, yes, काफी काम करते हैं इनसे आप तो I think it's very good that
Joshi is a economist and a very experienced marketer. My question is that how do we withstand the pressure from milk producers? Because when you want to become competitive, we have to reduce something for the farmers, and they are always shouting to increase the prices for the, because we want to keep the milk business sustainable. As soon as we reduce the milk prices, the dairy business will go down. And dairy is not a business in India, it is a sort of livelihood for millions of people. So we want a strong points from persons like Professor Joshi that see, our processing margin is very less. Hardly in cooperatives, it is 10 to 15% only. And we have hardly spend about 10-15% for marketing. Remaining everything goes back to the farmer. So how do we become competitive in such situation where we have a successive cooperative model? We are not competing with private or any other things. So this was one question I posed to Professor Joshi. I posed to him about what will happen to this commodity, because see, we are purchasing all the milk which is coming, and now we have piles of milk powder and butter fat, excess butter fat. So the situation is going to be worse after 1 or 2 months. So Professor Joshi, आप बोलिए, आप क्या कहना चाहते
हैं? I fully agree. Because, you know, you are very right, Prajapati Saab. Matlab, I was pointing to my colleagues in America and other part of the Europe. And what I have come to know is in America, the government is buying the milk and milk products, you know, to be distributed to the food banks who are distributing to the homeless people under the COVID. Now, India, you know, in this package, you talk 15,000 crore for infrastructure, but better that the government at all level buys these milk products for free distribution to the people. So this way, our milk will also be, because, you know, Prajapati ji, aapko pata hai ki I am working with various governments as well. So ye sab, jaise America ke alawa, Britain mein hai, Germany mein hai, they are buying the milk product from the farmers and they are, the government is paying the price to the milk product and distributing to the people. And other thing what they, the European countries do is to reduce the supply of milk, they pay money as well. So that they don't supply, so that we cannot pay. This system is not there. They have the quota system which will not go. But what I feel is under this pandemic, when so many millions of people have money, you know, last time I was also, I suggested 4-5 years back when we had a lot of stocks of the milk and government gave them the grant. That time there was a, you know, the earthquake in Nepal. And that time you are aware that, you know, I suggested, and then Basin Sahab, we wrote also to the government, government should buy this milk and supply free of cost to Nepal as a India's food act. So I think this is the best time that the government of India, you know, under, because they have a lot of money to feed the poor and the homeless in India and abroad as well. So ab aap doodh humse khareediye aur unko bechiye. Otherwise, ye 50% ka price dairies ke liye bada mushkil ho raha hai. Now, another thing, I also receive a, you know, question from Mr. Mann. From Mr. Mann in Sukhbir Singh Mann in Punjab. Wo kehta hai ki imported agar milk powder aayega, if the imported milk powder comes in India, to hamari price kam ho jayegi, to humko paise nahi milenge. Again, same thing. Now, I think I also wanted to, because I think we discussed a lot, and the thing is the you know, the supply plant, the plant, you know, the manufacturers, like ice cream manufacturer, unko to chahiye ki imported the powder, if it is a cheap, you know, cheap price, the another strategy. You know, you convert it into the you know, value added product. क्योंकि बाजार में डिमांड वैल्यूएटेड प्रोडक्ट की है. इन द होल वर्ल्ड $1.5 trillion ऑफ एग्रो फूड्स आर बेस्ड, आउट ऑफ व्हिच $1 trillion इज यू नो प्रोसेस्ड वन एंड 0.5 इज ओनली द यू नो द रॉ वन. वी आर मोर ऑन द रॉ रादर देन वैल्यूएटेड. इन केस द लो कॉस्ट मिल्क इज सप्लाई और इवन सप्लाइड और इवन द एसएमपी सप्लाइड टू द वैल्यूएटेड मैन्युफैक्चरर्स लाइक आइसक्रीम एंड ऑल अदर, so their cost of production goes less and they become competitive. Number one. Number two, there are various states in India, say Kerala, they are almost 90-90% you know, milk deficit. When we talk to various states, wo kehte hai ki we want imported milk kyunki unke yahan to doodh hota nahi hai. They don't want to buy a milk at high price from states like Punjab, Haryana and Gujarat and Rajasthan. Unko kam paise ka doodh chahiye. Aap samajh gaye? Acha. Imported milk at low price, it increases the welfare of the farmer, but it negatively, you know, impacts the welfare of the customer.
Sure, sir, sure.
Achha. So I think, therefore, I think there is no shortcut. Main kabhi aapko support nahi karunga inefficiencies ke liye. And you know very well, farmer ko price dena hai, theek hai, but cooperative ki inefficiency should not be tolerated. Farmer, professional management in cooperative and the top management, the politicians managing cooperative are three different entity. You support farmer, usme kitna paisa de to usko support karo, upar ke paise se aap kaat lijiye, to aapka doodh jo hai na competitive ho jayega. Try karo Prajapati sahab, aap to satta ke kareeb baithe hue ho.
I agree with you, and that last time Dr. Rajuri also suggested that we give this extra SMP, this midday meal school programs and other things, and government buy it. So government can help that way if they want, because there is lot many things. Similarly, वो घी का पर जो GST लगाया tax, वो भी avoid कर सकते हैं, so that excess buttermilk that can be used. So there are many things which government initiatives can do, and probably you can send a proposal to government from your side as an expert that this is advisable for Indian economy.
I keep on talking, don't worry, I keep on talking.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
My suggestion was there that we have to improve the productivity of the animals. That is more important. That will cost. That will also bring down the cost. Whatever there is a national livestock commission has got or Rashtriya Gokul Mission is there. Lot of money is coming from the government also, and everybody is supporting this cause to increase the milk production for animal productivity or animal and to become the free of this foot and mouth disease and other brucellosis. That will also boost the milk production and productivity of animals. But buying the importing the milk at this stage, I will not suggest, because whole dairy industry depending on the small and marginal farmers. I think more than 10 crore farmers are depending. And we have got very bright future, really marketing also there. Products are valuable, products are good margin, 25 to 30% margins are there. I did not find any dairy industry having sick problem or they get failure. Most of the dairy industry is surviving compared to other industries. Producers are getting everyday price. You can imagine within 1 week cash price is there compared to any other agriculture crop. So I think our milk producers are dairy industry is in a very bright future, but there are some of the things government has got disease control program. Even this mission is there, then MSN is 3 lakh crore is there for the development of the startup and the small giving the without collateral some of the loan. So I think that is the rural development will be also taking place. Those who are return to the native place or the labor migrants. And then any development will be as a whole will be growing. I think there is a lot of pride future that basically we have to improve the productivity on the animals and have a proper rationing and food.
Thank you. There was one more point. I was just seeing a message from a person called Jayati. She says she is operating a dairy farm in Gurgaon. Now, with the urban center, such farms have come, which are, wherein the producer is getting a better price because it supplies, assures the customer of a better price. So, now, incidentally, in Delhi and around areas, incidentally, I live in Gurgaon. So, in the nearby area, so many small farms have come up, which are supplying a milk, say, 50 rupees a liter, 70, 80 rupees a liter. So, they are getting a better price. So, the model, say, of having 50 cows, 40 cows, 30 cows, and the time will come when the customer will require a better, better quality of the milk and the milk products, and such small farm will come across metro cities and smaller cities to cater to the need of a typical customer.
Yeah, these commercial dairy farms are coming up everywhere with 100, 200 animals. And Absolutely. They are very close to the metro markets, and they are very supplying nice. The standard products. Maybe in the bottles like our Bhagyalakshmi, we have got. If there are so many brands available in the Bombay that cost about 100 liters of milk. They call it into milk or they make it the organic milk, but this is a backward and forward integration together. They produce their own milk, they process it, pack it, and brand it. So this is where people are sure about the quality, and some of the class of the society are there ready to pay. But basically, for a commercial dairy farming or small dairy farm, land is become very expensive around the periphery of all the cities. So they have to go interior. Well, land is available because fodder growing along with the milk production will be only the survival. It cannot just because you have to depend on 70% cost is there because of the fodder or of feed what we are feeding to animals. So unless you go to the interior and find out some of the byproducts of the agriculture after this harvest, then it becomes the most viable. That's why we have to bring down the cost of production by breeding, feeding and management properly. So I think that is a lot of work is done by NDPP, some of the other, or all these, our department, animal husbandry department, veterinary policy. So that is also helping to boost the milk production, improve the animal's health and everything.
Sure, sir. And also, on the point of increase of commercial dairy farms across metro cities, I believe, it is a very, it is catering to the demand of consumers very well. And if, by some scheme or by some educational measures, we can tell the farmers to, shift their focus from selling unorganized and, associating with these commercial dairy farms that have come up. So I think it will be, increasingly address the demand of consumers as well as help farmers to, gain more from the milk and all the produce that they're having. So this is a new industry chain that I think we'll see in the future.
Yeah, I don't think there is any scope for the loose milk. What we had earlier, middlemen or keeping some buffalo, sabela, that will slowly, slowly disappear. And the people are demanding the quality, branded, tracked product. They are sure about the quality. So there will not be any compromise. They would like to pay a little bit more, but make sure the quality should be okay.
Sure, sir. But the point is that if farmers directly sell to these, dairy commercial, commercial new units, I think if they pasteurize the milk and all, I think the farmers can benefit from that, and the economics of the complete production can be profitable, I suppose.
Yeah. So there will be a lot of scope will be there, but the improvement is required to improve the productivity of the animals and a breeding, that a breeding, feeding management is required. And there are a lot of sort of, professional training are going on by so many institutions, including Henry, to improve the quality, give the patient, apply the silage system, which will also help to improve the milk
production,
bring down the cost of milk production.
So one of the last questions, sir, I think we have seen a lot of interest from the visitors about, the SMP. So what is happening in the industry is that due to decrease in the demand from HoReCa industry, lot of cooperative and processing companies have shifted their focus to manufacture skim milk. Now, as we were discussing earlier, in the international markets, the product from India is not favored that well. So I think shifting to Mr. Joshi, Dr. Joshi, so just want to have your thoughts. So how this economics will be resolved, because these processors and cooperatives have a lot of surplus amount of finished SMP that is lying with them. Export is something that international market doesn't accept the product. So how will this economics be resolved in the near future?
So I think I answered this question. This is the same question with Dr. Prajapati asked. So only thing is two things. One is by having the evaluated product, balancing the demand, across the states. And the third one is by emphasizing on government buying the milk to be distributed under the various aid or the free programs. Because the demand in the international market, in the next 1 year is not going to give you a remunerative price. The international prices are already low enough. So that is the price even in the, and therefore again and again, I emphasize on cost competitiveness. I think the forecast for next 10 years, the price of say butter is going to remain almost stable. The price of, even in next 10 years, the price of cheese is not going to increase. The price of whole milk will increase. SMP will increase very marginally. But India, the cost of ingredients is increasing. So what I fear is in time to come, the Indian products could become more cost incompetitive in the international market. And not only international, because of the opening up of the economy, the foreign products also come. And as Dr. Parikh was very rightly said, that the Indian industry, the secret of success lies, I think, with the productivity. The India per cattle productivity is 1,100. Liters of milk in a year. In America, it is 8,000. In Israel, it is 14,000. So, what is it? Look at the difference. And I think there are a host of issues which we discussed at various forums that, your breeding program did not, there's so many breeding, insemination, field level, the productivity issues, many cows goes without insemination. So many issues that the productivity, and I'm very sure the government is doing. But, I'm a professor, I want the result, in the exam. It is not COVID-19 every time that you postpone the exam and that you don't want to give the result. Every time you say we are doing. But where is your productivity with 1100, which if you are doing with so many long years? Your productivity to 1100, Dr. Parikh will agree with me, is stable for last 10 years or even 20 years. You are not increasing the productivity and you say you are doing. What are you doing, you tell me? Actually, there is one more question which I wanted to, Dr. Parikh will answer you better because you cannot answer this question right now. COVID-19, the exams is postponed. Sir.
I just want to add on this about this surplus of the milk powder. I was told that every day now we are producing about 1,000 tons of the powder.
Very
milk market is not there much. And I think about 2 lakh tons powder is already of now dairy industry, but this is all what happened before 3-4 months. We have shortage of the powder, commodity market. But basically, government has to come somewhere to requirement of the working capital. Because our idea and all are we are telling you there should be some subsidized rate of interest have a loan to have some liquidate this of the kimmel powder and other products with the ghee or butter. So that is also a requirement that government should consider, because the cooperatives are getting some support through some other agencies or even NABARD, but not much support is coming to the private sector.
Sure, sure.
Yeah.
Okay, I think so, we had one more question in this, which was asked by Mayur Parekh. Mayur Parekh is a managing director in a big dairy in Ahmedabad, and he is an international technocrat who worked across African countries. So now Mayur bhai, Mayur ka question ye hai ki with lot of automation the employment will go. So I think automation or no automation, so he says that automation is not required if you want employment. I am sure that if you want to show the panelists, you can show him, Mayur bhai. But the problem is, please understand that this is my take is, because of the COVID and the problem in the labor, the company will move the automation, and automation is also required to maintain your quality as well. So I think we have to live with like we have to live with COVID, we have to live with automation, and automation is also required. We have to improve the quality, we have to improve the productivity in the production processes as well. But I think Mayur bhai, you know the ground realities better.
What
was there before 30 years? We are talking about the computers, when computer will come, so many jobs will go away. But you can see that there is nothing in effect, even the job generation has increased. Same thing, whenever there is automation is there, a lot of other avenue has been opened, So it is not that the automation will reduce the manpower or the thing. But you will have a better quality, productivity will improve, the capacity of the plant will have a more consistent product. And you can have many industries can develop on the engineering side, quality control side, packaging side. So I don't find, and entrepreneurship will develop more. Maybe employee may be reduced, but the productivity of the employees will also improve. So I think that's the right. And customer want that, product to make all the product is possibly more hygienic.
I think on the we just shifted the focus. I think for the SMP powder, I think any thoughts on that, Dr. Murthy, you would like to add? How do you think that will address the demand gap and the economics?
Yeah, there is a specific question by Mr. Gauri Sharma. He's saying that, under this COVID, how to make the product reach untouched to the consumer or the user. Okay. See, this was the point that was mentioned by Dr. Rakesh Mohan Joshi also, that typically the German model. In dairy, I tell you, the per liter, for a 50 kilometers travel of the product, we spend 50 paisa. So it is almost 1 paisa per liter per kilometer. It is substantially high. And the issue is preserving the quality right after the produce. Means after you milk the cow or the animal, the earliest you freeze, less the bacteriological growth. That is where the stability is ensured. And have a small production centers. And the chilling center is very close to the density of the last producing animals, so that the product does not travel a longer distances. And not necessary when we say an organized sector or a packing sector, it need not come with a great brands of ITC or Amul. That the interest is to protect the hygiene and the health of the consumer. So early you pack after the produce, the better hygiene is ensured there. Copy from the best of the progressive economies, where what they have done is the manufacturing or the form in which they would like to consume. Maybe it is different from what we consume, like in tea and all. In the milk itself, we consume. They go to the more processed additions. Here, issue is not the skimmed milk production. Issue is to the how to make it more hygienic in the production center itself. And the COVID, the migration is the biggest problem. The product migration and the logistics are major challenges. To ensure hygiene at the production itself and build around smaller packing centers, which are low in cost, affordable, and the distributions are very, very simple. You don't have to have a large network of the chains to distribute the products. So, the product price would not increase drastically, and quality is ensured by having simple steps right from the production to the chilling to the packing to the distributions. So this happens very fast and the shelf life is ensured. This is what I think, Gauri, I could answer your question.
Sure, sir. And yeah, I think this is...
I want to add only, once the milk is being produced, ABS generally is not telling about the clean milk production programs. So many places these programs are running, so how personal hygiene is required. Wherever you have got the milking area, giving the animal to the shower, or keeping the, all the, you know, barn very much clean. And immediately, I possibly forgot the size of the farm. We can put some milking parlor also there. All bucket milking, pretty small, is there. And you can have a properly CIT system of the cleaning. And immediately after the milk production, if it can be chilled with some BFC or any chilling, and then you can have a small mini dairy processing plant where you can pasteurize and pack it and have a cold chain to the consumer. So I think from production to the forward integration to the consumer, even we have got put many mini small dairy plants, 5,000 liters to 2,000 liters. But this cold chain and hygiene practices has to be followed, you know, taking the care of the animals, seeing that farm is free of all the disease, other things, all the properly maintaining rations and doing that, and personal hygiene, keeping the other clean, this and that. So that will certainly help, and immediately milk has to be chilled. That is more important. After chilling, you can process it, stop, and that you can market it with a brand. So that will give the good quality of the product, because it is your own farm-produced milk compared to brought-out milk. So that is what you may call as a organic milk or more hygienic milk, something like that.
Sure, sir. And I think, you know,
this very, very valid point that you have mentioned. Yeah.
Sure. This is a very, I think, the pressing question of the hour, because, you know, as of now, we need to shift focus on to how we can, you know, package products and sell it more economically. Thanks, Murthy sir, and thanks, Dr. Parekh, for, you know, putting light on this situation. So I think while we were going through the session, we have already almost addressed all of the Q&As. So thanks for all the experts and all the panelists, especially Mr. Rakesh Mohan Joshi, who, you know, motivated us to let Mr. Prajapati join and we can have his points as well. Thanks for valuable inputs, and over to you, Soumya. Soumya, you're on mute.
Yeah. So thanks, Prajapati sir, for joining. It was great having you with us on the panel. So Prajapati sir needs no introduction. Prajapati sir is associated with Anand Agriculture University and a great researcher in dairy sector. Thanks, Joshi sir, for getting us listen to Prajapati sir. After the great insight of our panelists, I would not be wrong if I say milk is not a commodity but a habit for us all. We really appreciate the front warriors, that is our farmers, who are working day and night to provide us the same. Rightly said by all our speakers for the dairy, to get the right amount of produce, we need to have quality infrastructure in place. And I am proud to announce, in line with India becoming Atmanirbhar, and Agnext has come up with a very cost-effective quality testing solution for milk. I would like you all to just have a look to our solution for the same. So Agnext has come up with a milk quality assessment solution wherein from our device, from our solution, we can test the composition and contamination within less than 30 seconds, wherein composition, we can test fat, SNF and protein, and adulteration testing, we can test vegetable oil, detergent, starch, urea, melamine, salt and sugar. So you can see the device in the group here. So this is a device which is as small as handy as a mouse, and it is Bluetooth enabled, battery operated handheld device, and which works in coherence with mobile application, and rapid assessment of quality can be done within 30 seconds of time. And also we have come up with the ITC. We have partnership with ITC to come up with a solution for aflatoxin testing also.
Since we have presence of Mr. Dr. Parekh and also experts from the industry, so I would just like to take this, advantage of the situation to introduce that, you know, the basic objective of Agnes introducing this very portable solution was to, you know, incorporate adulteration testing at the very beginning of the stage where farmers get connected at the collection centers. So in the supply chain, as of now, we see, you know, all these big sophisticated devices are installed at milk plants, or even are installed at some of the milk chilling centers. But since there is no effective solution for adulteration testing at the, you know, first contact of farmer at collection centers, it is difficult, and the adulteration is kind of you know, seeps into the supply chain. So, you know, keeping into the mind the economics, the feasibility of plants and cooperatives to invest in very affordable solution for adulteration testing, this was something that we brought. So any thoughts on this, Mr. Parikh, Dr. Parikh, or Dr. Joshi? I think it will be great.
Yeah, I think this will be very useful. Now people are becoming more conscious about the quality of the product and give the, you know, end-to-end solution. So certainly this type of, because people are now becoming quality conscious. Now earlier we used to have a little bit more price conscious, but now because as people have some of the mind that some milk is adulterated, this and that, but this will give 100% solution that yes, milk is completely free from any adulterants or neutralizer. So I think a lot of scope is there to have this type of instrument in the dairy field, and it can be worked excellent job. But only as you were mentioning earlier, some of the scientists from our EDCT has also developed what we call atmospheric cold plasma technology. It is like giving some treatment to the dairy product at the time of exit, you know, like what we have some metal detector, where you can be sure that the product packaging is completely free from the coronavirus. So this type of technology also got a lot of future. But online testing of the all the products in the pipeline, hygienic, and from the farm to the consumer, is I think their instrument will be very useful, and it's at the right time, and I find a lot of scope here in the future and present here.
Thanks, sir. We just want to also introduce that we have partnered with ITC for providing aflatoxin testing into the milk as well. So I would ask Dr. Murthy to give his some comments on it and how this will impact the industry. So some points, Dr. Murthy.
Yeah. We are working with Agenext in developing the quick and rapid solutions to help the industry build the quality. Agenext comes out with the technology, and we are happy working with a very agile and highly caliber team. ITC comes out with the product expertise, jointly will go to the market. Aflatoxins, we have a solution that is 350 rupees per test, vis-a-vis HPLC test of 2,500 rupees per test. This can be field deployed. It is a very small one. Anyone can carry. It does not require a sophisticated laboratory. Idea is to make it affordable, make it cheap, and make decisions before you buy so that product is safe right across the value chain. Once you buy, reaches at the point of skim milk and you test it, find it not good, then you know it is more a reactive approach. So Agenext and ITC are trying to build solutions to test the product right at the farm level. And we also have a solution for testing protein A1 and A2, which the market in India is yet to catch up. It's a simple RT-PCR technique, again, can be tested at a field level. So we have a wide range of solutions for the dairy and the milk testing, right from the adulterations explained by Soumya before, and aflatoxin solutions, and protein testings.
Sure,
anyone interested from the government or from the private sector would look to have a demonstration or like to have more details in terms of the performance, we would be more than happy to share those details with you all. Thank you.
Thanks, sir. Thanks for the inputs. Over to you, Soumya.
So with this, we would like to have the opportunity to thank our respected panelists, Dr. Parikh, Dr. Joshi, Dr. Murthy, Chakrabarty sir, and Prajapati sir, for taking out time and addressing our participants. I would also like to thank our team, Salil, Gurpreet, Inosh, and Jyoti, for taking out time. We would also like to ensure that our participants, if any question of yours has not been addressed in the webinar, please feel free to drop us an email. Stay safe and namaskar.
Namaskar. Thanks all the panelists for joining. It was great to hear your expert views, sir.
Thank you very much for inviting.
It is great to join you all on the board. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you. God bless you all. Have a nice week. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Dr. Joshi and Dr. Murthy.
Okay, thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Great interacting with you all. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.